In this video, we're gonna be talking about how to use a drill brush to clean cloth seats. Now, let's get straight into it. What's going on? So glad you guys are here and welcome back to the Wilson Auto Detailing community. If you are a professional auto detailer who wants to become more successful and profitable in your business, or just a car enthusiast who wants to improve your detailing ability, then definitely consider hitting that big red subscribe button right below this video. So right now I am working on some cloth seats that I'm gonna show you guys. This is just a Hyundai Sonata. This is a new client of mine. So I'm just gonna kind of pan around so you guys get a good idea of what these look like right now. Now these specific cloth seats are what I call the impossible fabric, the impossible carpeted seats, or the cloth seats, because even though they are cloth and you'd think, well, I'll just extract it, steam it, whatever, this kind of material is such a tight weave. It's so tight. It's like felt. It's like fabric felt. It's very difficult to get clean. So I'm going to show you guys kind of a strategy that helps me become more efficient and actually get great results at the same time without using big, expensive products and tools. So basically, the product that I'm going to be using for the duration of this video is going to be Super Clean Degreaser Diluted 5:1, because once again, these seats are pretty hammered, so I want a degreaser. It's gonna be stronger than just a regular all-purpose cleaner. I'm gonna use my DeWalt power drill right here. It's about $100, and I'm gonna use this soft brush head attachment. Now, I do have another attachment that I use for carpeted ones. Now, the attachment that I use for the carpet is kind of like a tile and grout bristle kind of grade sponge, so it's a lot tougher, and if I were to use that one on these cloth seats, it would kind of fray the fabric and hurt the fabric, and so that's why I'm not doing that. Not to mention, if you are going to use the same grade drill brush for the carpet and the seats, for obvious reasons, you're going to want to use a different one for the carpets and the seats, because you don't want to take all that soiled crap that you get from the carpets onto the cloth seats, because cloth seats don't quite get the same grease and grime that carpets do. So that's probably pretty obvious. And then the last thing that I'm going to be using is my VX5000 steamer. Now, many of you guys probably do not own the VX5000 steamer, because you probably don't have any need of a steamer that's that high grade. But once again, because I'm seeing cars every day and I'm a professional auto detailer, I do want one that's kind of more industrial. However, of course, like always, I will hook up less expensive steamers at the end of this video for you guys to check out in the description box below, because there are other steamers that give just as good results. Now, let's get into this strategy. Now, I know this is not the best angle, but it's better for me to do it like this so the camera isn't shaky, rather than me holding it in one hand and then spraying with the other hand. So all I'm gonna do is take first my Super Degreaser Diluted 5:1 here, and I'm going to spray it all over the cloth seat just like this. Now, in this scenario, some people kind of freak out about using too much cleaner because they say it's going to soak down into the foam, all that sort of stuff. The truth behind that really is, in order for it to become devastating, for solution to actually soak into the foam beneath this fabric, you would really have to use a lot, and not to mention using an extractor will do that anyways, because you're spraying most of the time so much water. I'm not going to be extracting any of this, and so I'm not going to be using a bunch, but you can see I'm not being super conservative with it, and it's really not something that needs to be like overthought. It's pretty simple, really. You're not gonna hurt anything by using the amount that I just used. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and treat this whole area right here, that where we sit, and I'm gonna get the front area here as well as the sides, which might be a little out of the view of the camera. But as you guys can see, I'm not being extremely conservative. Now, my next step is very literally just going to take my drill brush, and this is probably very straightforward, but I'm gonna pull the trigger and it is going to brush for me. The reason why these work so well is because it's something you can't do by hand. You can't brush this fast by hand. And of course, the faster I'm brushing here, the more friction I'm creating, the more stains I'm gonna be pulling up, the more that degreaser is gonna be able to kind of work to its highest potential. So I'm gonna kind of probably speed up half of this and then let half of the first half be slow so you guys can see. So check this out. Okay, so now that I've done that, you kind of have two options. I could just go ahead and mop this up and kind of be done. Now, once again, I'm not going to extract these seats because just based off my experience and based on what I know about this car, extracting this is not going to improve anything to really any high degree. Extracting for cloth seats a lot of times is really reserved for spills and things like that. Not in every case, but once again, in this case, I'm not going to be extracting. So I can go ahead and mop it up with a microfiber, or I can actually take my steamer and hit it with my steamer first, which is what I'm gonna do. So you don't have to do this, but I'm gonna go ahead and hit this area with my steamer. And this, of course, is the simplest part. I'm just gonna take a microfiber towel and go ahead and mop it up. Now, one little kind of tip that I don't really hear a lot of people talk about with these kind of cloth seats, when you're using a microfiber to mop it up, I would say that each section gets the best results when you use a completely dry microfiber. So after I'm done with like this, 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 and this, I'll just get a new microfiber altogether. And for each section, I'm gonna use a different dry side. So I've mopped this up right here. Now I'm gonna flip to the dry side and mop this up. And of course that may be obvious, but sometimes we just kind of overlook things like that as a detailer because we're seeing so many cars on a daily basis or on a weekly basis or whatever. But once again, you're gonna get the best results with just a completely new microfiber towel, or completely new as in completely washed and cleaned and not used yet. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish all of the seats in the entire car, drivers, passengers, and backside seats, and then bring you guys in for the finished look and kind of explain some things just to conclude. All right, guys, so here is the after, and I'm gonna go kind of show you guys the whole different lighting. So I'm gonna go to the other side as well, but here's the back seats from this angle. I'm gonna go ahead and go to the other side of the car. I actually went and just finished detailing the car as well so that you guys could just see the finished product, but here's the seats afterwards, and here's a picture of the before. Now you guys can see in the before there's a tons of stains, tons of crumbs, all that stuff. Obviously that's all gone, but now you guys can see there are still a few splotchy areas, and that's because some of these places are still drying. I'm gonna go ahead and show you the front as well. So here is the driver's seat. I know the lighting makes it difficult. Hopefully we can focus in. And then here is the passenger seat as well. Still a couple ununiform spots. But one thing that I would like to say about this car in particular is simply that this is a like 8-year-old car now, never been detailed, doesn't have any protection, anything like that, no floor mats. And so there is going to be a level of staining imperfection that you have to expect because once again, detailers are kind of more beneficial when we can protect before we actually clean. When something's not been protected and we're just trying to kind of finish or kind of clean up the aftermath, this is the kind of results you're gonna get. Of course, is that 100% perfection? Well, not at all. But am I looking for 100% perfection? No, I am not. So basically the idea is that the drill brush and the power drill and of course the steamer, but mainly the drill brush, not only gives you better results, but it also makes you much quicker, and of course better results, less time. That's the winning combination I'm looking for. So if you guys would like to get your hands on a drill brush or even the steamer and some less expensive steamers that I also suggest for the auto detailing world, of course I always hook up everything I use in my videos in the description box below. So if you'd like to buy any of those, definitely use the Amazon links below because it does give this channel a very small commission, but it helps this channel stay alive so I can continue to give out awesome content just like this all the time. Of course, if you like this video, hit the thumbs up button. And if you have any questions, comments, concerns, hook up all that stuff in the YouTube comments below because I always read those and I'm sure to get back to you guys as fast as I can. And of course, if you are new here, then definitely consider subscribing because I come out with videos all the time just like this on products, tools, strategies, communication skills, business skills, and so much more, all in an effort to help the pro detailers become more successful and profitable in their businesses. And on this channel, I share the same strategies that turned my business into a full-time income with only part-time hours. So if you're interested in that, definitely subscribe. Once again, thank you guys so much for being involved here. And as always, from Luke here at Wilson Auto Detailing, keep working hard, and I'll see you guys in the next video.